morning, Thursday morning, have a really interesting day, including a visit to a company that I discovered on Indiegogo, a company that I backed. Didn't even know they were in Israel. Going to their offices today, going to meet a really, really cool company called HumanEyes that has a 360 camera that I've also heard about for years, never been to their offices. A whole bunch of cool things. Tonight, the Jerusalem Wine Festival, the annual Jerusalem Wine Festival. It's gonna be awesome. And then the weekend. So yeah. Pretty excited about this day. All right, so I made it to this place outside of Jerusalem to see this company called HumanEyes that has a 360 camera. I've never been in this place before. It's kind of stunning. It's like 5 minutes outside of Jerusalem. It's beautiful here. Also, new specs. A friend of mine has a new glasses website and he hooked me up. What do you think? Going into the meeting now. Hopefully we'll get some cool interviewing. HumanEyes, in a company that is leading the way in the VR and 360 space. Anyway, I've heard of this company literally for the last 4 or 5 years. Easily 100 people told me I have to meet them. So finally, Israel Blechman, the guy you guys met last week on the vlog, said he's working with them, and I'm like, dude, make an intro. I gotta see this technology. And so I came here, and I saw this UFO. It's not really a UFO. We'll talk about what that is in a second, but first, who are you?
Yes, hi, hello, I'm Rutha, Aronson, VP Products and Marketing at HumanEyes.
HumanEyes, so HumanEyes is the name of the company, yes. And the name of the product is?
Vuze,
V-U-Z-E.
Right.
Awesome. So the company's kind of been around, has built some remarkable technology in the 360 space, and this is your new baby.
Right.
So what is Vuze?
Yes, Vuze.
Yeah. What is Vuze?
Yes, Vuze is very easy to use 3D 360 virtual reality camera.
Okay, so hold on, that's a mouthful.
Yes.
A lot of times people mix up 3D and 360. Most people do.
Yeah.
Because, you know, at the end of the day, it's immersive content, and so they don't really see the difference, but there's a very, very big difference. Can you explain to me in simple terms, what is the difference between 3D and 360?
So 360, when we say 360, we mean that we capture everything around us, okay? 360 degrees around us, 180 degrees above and below. So we have the full sphere.
So real life.
It is all around, everything that happens. So this camera captures everything around.
Is this a tripod? I can close this?
Yes.
How do I close this?
Yes.
I don't want to break it. Oh, wow, that is super cool. So I can hold it like this. That is sexy. You just showed me some content here on a VR headset and on an accessory that you have here on a regular phone. Like, I mean, I felt like I was in real life. It's real.
Yeah.
It's wild. And you know what's interesting, I find at least, I don't know if anyone's ever said this to you before, but Israelis are very good at building tech. Generally speaking though, they're a little bit rusty when it comes to product, when it comes to polish. You guys did an amazing job here. This is built like,
thank you.
It feels great in the hand and it looks great. It's amazing, and this little tiny thing here captures that, and it's 4K. So just tell me real quick, just a little bit about the company. How many people work here?
Well, we are currently over 30 people.
30 people.
We have grown in the last few years since we started to work on the camera.
Amazing, and you guys launched how long ago?
We've launched this March.
And 6 months ago, around.
6 months ago.
And this is $800?
$800 US, yes.
$800 US. So where can people buy it?
Well, they can go online.
Just buy it on your website.
Vuze.camera, and we have our online store. That would be the easiest.
Vuze.camera, V-U-Z-E.camera. I love it. Where do I buy? I'm gonna buy one.
Yeah.
Thank you for that interview.
And welcome.
This is amazing.
Thank you.
Amazing. Breaking news. What are you giving me?
I am going to give you an amazing Vuze camera.
What colors does it come in?
So you can choose from black, yellow, blue, and red.
And red?
Yes.
You had me at red. Let's do this. Wow. So there's this company called Mego that I have seen on the internet for years. I backed them, at least one of their projects. I didn't know they were in Israel. I definitely didn't know they were in a place called Abu Ghosh. Never been here. I live 15 minutes away. Never been here before. This place is making an insane amount of noise on the internet. This is the entire office.
I'm Rafi. I am the CEO of the company.
CEO, who are you?
Hey, marketing. Migo's marketing.
Head of marketing.
Katya.
Katya. Oh my gosh. Look at this place. Who are you?
Hi. I'm the designer, Alona.
You're doing magic. All right, let's see.
Turns your camera into a DSLR.
It takes, not just, it turns your iPhone into a DSLR.
Show it to me. Turns your iPhone into a DSLR. I just need to bring my iPhone and a picked up. Give me a second.
This goes on your iPhone and literally turns into a DSLR. You can see it. Pictar. Migo.com. Gotta go check this thing out. They have the most amazing, amazing, amazing product. Migo.com. Let me see what else is going on here. Wow.
is the PR office.
What? What?
It really is. The entire marketing and PR is made from out of this room.
And you have a lot of PR. You have a lot of coverage on the internet. I've seen you everywhere.
Plenty of coverage. That's amazing. True.
My name is Rafi David.
Rafi David. And you are, where are you from originally?
Belgium.
Oh, I love it. I love Belgium. Okay. Not that I've been. I want to go there, but okay.
I've been in Israel for, I think it's 10 years now.
Okay.
All the founders of Migo, we all work in a company called Kata.
Qatar?
Kata.
Kata.
K-A-T-A.
Like karate Kata?
Karate Kata, which okay. was, I can say at a certain point, the second largest camera bag manufacturer in the world.
Get out of here.
Wow. Based in Jerusalem. Yes.
Amazing.
The company was acquired about 7 years ago by a group called Manfrotto, okay. Vita Group. Okay. About 4 or 5 years ago, they decided to downsize the office in Israel and move all the operations to Italy. This is when we decided, all of us together, that
we know
the business.
You founded this company? You're the only founder?
No. Lona's a founder, Ohad is a founder, okay. Guy who usually sits...
How many founders? Four?
Five founders.
Five founders. And how many people in the whole team?
No, we're about nine people.
Nine people! The amount of noise that you guys make on the internet, I thought you were at least 50. Unbelievable.
This is something, we must be doing something right.
Yeah, 100%. So what do you make? You make bags? Some of the coolest bags
out there. So we started with our first project on Kickstarter, which was a grip for a camera, a grip and a strap, which is a strap that morphs into a bag.
A grip, a strap for a camera that morphs into a bag?
A bag, yes.
Okay.
We saw a decline in people taking these huge cameras with them. People are starting to
except for this thing,
take
I walk around
mirrorless
with,
cameras.
This is what I do for you guys, yeah.
People take mirrorless cameras with them, so this is where the mirrorless segment is going.
Right.
But the big segment of cameras, people who used to buy the DC, the Nikon D60 and take pictures of their kids is right. Shrinking.
Of course, because this thing.
Because it does this thing. So the first thing we did is, first of all, give them a way to carry it on their everyday life.
Okay.
So making different solutions to bring your phone, your camera.
These bags look amazing, by the way. Just
thank you very much.
Amazing, yeah.
The second collection we came out with is the Agua collection, which is the collection you see there.
Okay, the ones we just looked at, yeah.
Yes. This gives us a solution that was never done before, which is waterproof bags that are very easy and comfortable.
I loved your video with the Mother Nature.
Ding.
Loved it. Alright, yeah, so it's mud-proof, waterproof, dust-proof,
yes,
full, and it looks amazing.
Looks amazing, and it's got a lot of smart design, design solutions.
Thank you so much.
We currently sell it in about, I think it's 35 countries in photographic stores.
Unbelievable. How much they cost?
The cheapest one is $49,
nothing.
Up to $200.
Amazing.
So it depends on which model you want.
Do you understand how many, because I literally have a humongous closet at home.
You're a bag man.
That's my tech closet, right? You see my tweet yesterday?
Yeah, I did.
So I said I'm not a bag man?
Yeah.
Because I said I'm not a bag man, but I backed you guys. But I have literally, I have a closet of tech. I have endless phones, endless, iPads, tablets, endless drones. I have a whole drone collection. I have the DJI Mavic and DJI Spark right here, but I have at home at the Bebop and all kinds of others, whatever it is. And bags is the biggest pain. Because right now, look what I have to carry. You know what I have in my car right now? You can't even imagine. I can't carry everything. You guys have, your bags basically have slots for everything, including charging. It charges your phone.
Charges your phone.
How does that work? You have to charge the bag. How often do you have to charge the bag?
You have to charge the bag. So you decide on which battery you use inside.
How many milliamp hours is the battery?
You can decide the battery. So you don't have to buy a new battery. The bag just comes with a solution to put your battery inside the bag, and then you just charge the bag. You use your battery.
Okay.
You plug it inside the bag.
When you get a battery pack?
Get the battery pack.
Okay.
You zip it close, and from that moment on, you're charging the bag.
That is so cool. That is so cool. Okay, cool. So wait, what's this latest thing that you guys...
So the latest thing we are doing is Pictar. And this was launched on Indiegogo about a year ago. When you put in the camera, or put in the phone, which turns into your camera, you have to exactly, it feels right.
Right. Okay, so this basically turns your iPhone into a full-blown DSLR, because what are the controls that you have here?
So you can control quite everything. You need to use the Pictar app, so it's a connected product, you need to use the app.
All right, so it's a Pictar app,
Pictar app.
Okay.
And then once it's connected, you can do a lot of things. The first thing you can do is you can focus lock.
Super duper cool.
Take a picture.
So but doesn't the iPhone do that automatically anyway?
Most people don't know how to use it, because the real problem is that Apple prepares all these functions for you and no one's using them.
So you half press it?
Half press and full press.
Like every camera.
Like on my regular camera. The second thing you can do here is change the exposure compensation.
Wow.
And everything you're doing is...
Did you see the video that Apple put out a couple months ago about all the tricks you can do for iPhone photography?
Yes.
So you can do this all here.
Exactly. Yeah. It's important to say that everything is controlled by sound.
Can I just... I got
not by Bluetooth.
Oh, so it's... Oh, wow.
So...
Wait, may I? I just want to see if I can get some of this in here.
You can change modes like a regular DSLR.
And okay, here, so you have manual mode, you have shutter priority.
Changing exposure right now. You can change exposure on this thing. I mean, it's literally just, it's a DSLR, but it's your iPhone. When I take pictures of my food, which I do every day, I ask the person I'm sitting with to give me their phone to put on the flashlight so I can take a picture that looks nicer. Right. So this way you can put your light. I have six lights at home for my camera.
If I put my picture in manual mode, this button is now shutter speed. This button is now ISO.
So you How do I even control shutter speed on the iPhone?
You do control the shutter speed, so you do
automatically though. You can do manual on the iPhone?
Yes.
How?
Exactly. This is one of the things that people don't know. Apple unlocked this for a long time ago.
There's many apps. Show me how I do this.
You can't do it in the Apple.
You can. Oh, so you can only do it in your thing.
You can just do it in my thing. There's other apps that allow you to do it.
So that's even more than you can do on the iPhone. That's amazing. Wow, that's amazing. Unbelievable. How much does this nice gadget cost?
It retails for $100.
It's nothing. It's nothing. Thank you should have charged five times that. No, not five times. But wait, so now it's on Indiegogo.
No, it's already in retail.
It's in retail. Wait, what are you selling on Indiegogo? The bags on Indiegogo now.
We have
so this is in retail. Project. So how do people buy this?
People buy it at B&H, Adorama, Amazon is going into Brookstone.
B&H is a sponsor. They sent me this. They sent me everything. All my equipment, B&H.
Yeah, they're a great customer for us.
All the drones, everything.
But they're a great customer for us, B&H.
Love B&H. Wait, so it's okay, but can you buy direct or just... Yeah. What's the website?
MyAmigo.com.
MyAmigo.com, and it's called?
Pictar.
And $100, you get this thing that turns your iPhone, any iPhone, by the way, any iPhone.
Any iPhone. So there's two sizes. One size from the 4 until the 7, and one for the 7.
This is the
plus
7
one.
Plus? What is this?
This is 7 Plus.
Yeah, so this is 7 Plus also.
So you can use it with...
Fits with a case?
You can use it with or without a case. So this one has a case on it.
Any case?
The smaller cases work.
I don't think this will work. Oh, what? What? Love it. Amazing. All right, I gotta get me one of these. Amazing. I'm gonna turn this thing off. You're gonna show me some more stuff. Cool. Thank you.
Thank you.
So I think that was a pretty remarkable morning. You got to see some unbelievable tech in the most random places, Abu Ghosh. And now we're eating lunch. The appetizer just arrived. Who are you, man?
I'm a punk captain. I'm this crazy guy that has been starting different organizations for the past years, and now I decided that I'm going to start a startup.
He studied law. He's a lawyer. He was a lawyer. And he's built a lot of NGOs, a lot of different nonprofits, and now he's like coming in the opposite direction. He's like, I'm good at building stuff. I want to do something meaningful. I want to build a startup. Usually people find a pain point and then build a startup. He wants to build a startup. Now he's going to find the pain point. So that's what we're discussing. That was the appetizer. Wait till you see the main. Are you ready? Are you sitting down? A day it's been. Heading home now, getting ready, and going to the Jerusalem Wine Festival. Seriously on the fence whether to bring this camera or not. Probably won't end up bringing it. If I do, you'll get to enjoy it with me. If not, take my word for it, the Jerusalem Wine Festival is awesome. Today, I came back with endless new toys. It's a good day when you come home with endless new toys. This week was pretty awesome as well. Later.